Welcome back, YCN Sports Talk. One final segment. Jeremy Stout, Dave Collins. And Dave, we have some hockey coming up.
We do. Friday night, new show debuts at 6:30, YCN Sports Wrap. He'll cover the high school scene. Andrew Zerthide will do that. And that'll be immediately followed by live college ice hockey Friday at 7 here on YCN. Miami of Ohio will be at Western Michigan. Congrats to the Big Green, too. They knocked off Michigan in their debut up at Thompson Arena.
Homecoming weekend. I think awesome. They might be the only team that got a win.
Yeah.
Maybe?
Yeah, the soccer team didn't know.
Both soccer football, teams lost, football lost.
Field hockey, yeah.
Women's volleyball, I was there. Everybody lost.
Okay. Winners, though. Let's talk about winners. And a guy that brought a championship to the Celtics in 2008. And really, you know, I couldn't stand the Celtics growing up in the 80s. But since I moved here in 2006, I don't really have a basketball team. I like Dallas. Ray Allen, though, in the Big Three. I mean, something's got to be said for that. And they almost did it a couple years later against the Lakers. They were this close.
Okay, so what will you remember Ray Allen for? I was thinking, you know, you whether he takes the championship for the Celtics, he hits that big shot against Miami a couple years ago, a great free throw shooter, and you're going to remember him for something different.
Great three-point shooter too, but Roger Ebert, remember the famed Siskel and Ebert, an athlete who can act, and he got game with Denzel Washington.
Yes.
I can't even think about how old that movie is. Makes me feel old.
I don't know how
Makes
old.
Me go gray up here, whatever hair I have left. But congratulations to Ray Allen and all the Big Three too. That was a memorable season, and it brought the Celtics their first championship since the 80s.
And that was the first Big Three and the first super team, whatever you want to call it. But did it seem like, because the Celtics had suffered for so long, we're getting off on a little bit of a tangent here, but it didn't seem like it was a bad thing. It was kind of harmless. Now you look at everyone hated LeBron going to the Heat, and now everyone hates the Warriors and Kevin Durant because they just won and they were in it. But the Celtics had suffered for so long, it almost felt like people rallied around them.
It's the attitude, and I also think the fact that they played the Lakers as well, and they knocked off LeBron back in 08.
Right,
that had a lot to do with
it. So it got a lot of people rallying around them as the process was going on.
Okay. Us against the world.
Right. So now going into the present day, Celtics play at home tonight against the Bulls, trying to avenge a loss in Game 2. And Al Horford is out tonight. Concussion in practice, he's out.
Brad Stevens.
I know it's early.
It's only November. Brad Stevens will get a hold of this team. And I think around Christmas is when we'll be able to tell what the Celtics are as far as the Eastern Conference goes.
Right. They have a home game tonight against the Bulls, who have surprised so far, played well. I think they're 3-0. And then they go tomorrow to face Cleveland on the road.
Derrick Rose isn't with the Bulls anymore. He's with the Knicks. He's sort of like the Carmelo Anthony. You know, the Knicks can't win without Carmelo Anthony. Maybe the Bulls can do something without Derrick Rose this season.
All right. And now it's time for our YCN Sports Talk Salt Hill Pub Picks of the Week.
Salt Hill Pub, located in Lebanon, Hanover, Newport, and the Sunapee Traffic Circle. Say hello to Josh and Joe and have a great meal.
All right, let's get right into the picks. AFC East, Jets go to Miami, face the Dolphins.
What a big win for the Jets at Cleveland last week. Whoopee. Yeah, great. All right, Dolphins are 3.5-point favorites. I still like the Jets, though. Maybe they can turn this around. I think it's New England in the AFCs. You know, you're just playing for second place.
Dolphins have been playing well. They're back at home. I picked the Dolphins in this one. Go to the NFC East, Eagles and Giants. We mentioned this one a little while ago, and Giants coming off a bye.
Yeah, you never want to lose back-to-back games in your own division. The Eagles lost to Dallas on Sunday night. Big game coming up at the Giants. New York favored by 3 points right now. I want to say the Eagles will pull it out, but also maybe Eli Manning steps up. It's November now. Maybe he pulls out a big game for the Giants. I'll take the Eagles, though.
Okay, I'm going to go against you there and take the Giants. They beat the Rams in London. Not too impressive. But they have the Browns coming up, the Bengals coming up, and this one might be that catapult that gets them into the playoff contention. Probably not the NFC East contention, though. Panthers-Rams. Panthers on the road. They beat the Cardinals last week. Does it look like this team's gelling? They should be able to beat the Rams.
I think so. And the Rams were pretty good, about 4 or 5 weeks ago. The game is on the road for Carolina. They're favored by 3 points. Cam Newton, if he can get past not being hit, I think he'll have a big game, too, and beat the Rams.
All right, and it's a lot easier going East Coast to West Coast than it is coming the other way around. So I take the Panthers as well. Sunday Night Football, we've already touched on it a couple times, Broncos-Raiders.
As we record this, it's a pick'em game right now.
Yeah,
I think the Raiders, if they can win this, they're in the driver's seat for the AFC West. Broncos can knock them off. Then it's the Broncos, the Chiefs, and the Raiders all sort of bunched up right there in the AFC West. I like the Raiders in this one, though.
I agree with you. Raiders there. David Carr is playing well. He's got a couple good receivers. Defense is pretty well for Denver. I just don't like that offense. They're not good enough yet.
Yeah.
Monday Night Football, Bills and Seahawks.
What will be thrown on the field up in Seattle this week? Seahawks are 6.5-point favorites. Rex Ryan needs this game, or else he's going to look like a joke for the rest of the season right now. After in New England, right. I know it was a closer game at the end. Buffalo tried to contend. New England could have wiped them up and down the field out in Orchard Park. Seahawks are 6.5-point favorites. I give the nod to Seattle. I think it's going to be a long season for Western New York fans again.
Right.
Over and over again, as long as Belichick's in New England.
And Seattle, I'm picking Seattle. Yeah. They're coming off a tough loss on the road to New Orleans, and I really think they need this game.
They're at home.
Right, yep. They're at home, so they're sitting pretty decent. Obviously, Arizona losing last week to Carolina, so they are in control in that division.
And that
but you
Rams
can't
too.
Lose. You can't right, but you can't lose at home on Monday night to the Bills.
No, you can't because you don't really have good. You don't really have good competition in the NFC West too. Right. San Francisco's not doing anything. Rams could lose against the Panthers. Seahawks need to win this.
All right, those are our picks. One final time, what do we have for local games coming up this weekend?
Local games, we've got Lebanon at Hanover, 3:30 kickoff on Saturday. That was moved back because of the SATs. And right here on YCN, Middlebury will take on Hartford in the Vermont football playoffs. The kickoff is at 7 o'clock on Friday. We'll have it on YCN. It debuts Monday at 7:30 with Chris Garrett and Andrew Zurheide on the call right here on YCN. YCNNow.com is the website. And sportstalk at YCNNow.com if you have any comments or memorabilia. Our wall needs to be filled up.
Yeah. A little bit more. He's Dave Collins. I'm Jeremy Stout. Thanks for watching YCN Sports Talk.